dream that one day, even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, would be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream.
In 1968, America was being torn apart. It was involved in Vietnam, and civil rights legislation had been pushed through, but black Americans were saying it's not enough. We want to turn to more radical solutions.
You had, at that time, Dr. Martin Luther King and his followers. You had Malcolm X and his followers.
American unity sees the only hope for the black man in America in a strong Africa.
And Black Power was saying, we want change now, and we insist on it. This isn't just a request, this is a demand.
Very few people had the avenue to tell people how it really was or how we felt about a certain issue. You had to have a platform.
To win gold medals for one's country and still feel a second-class citizen is the bitter paradox facing many colored Americans.
Because we were black athletes, what we were supposed to do is run real fast and go home, smile, get pats on the back, and still be relegated to second-class living.
Tommie Smith sets a new world record in the 200 meters with John Carlos taking the bronze.
And I'm supposed to stand up there and look at a flag, put my hand over my heart, saying how proud I am because this flag has represented me? I don't think so, because it did not. So when the national anthem started playing, I was not looking at the ground. I was praying, the Lord's Prayer. My head bowed and my fist went up in the air. I wore black gloves to represent social power or black power. I wore socks, not shoes, to represent poverty. I wore a black scarf around my neck to symbolize the lynching, the hangings that black folks went through while building this country.
And their fists clenched defiantly in the air. I think that that is one of the most abiding political images of the entire century.
Of course, remember the images of the Black Power salute on the rostrum. And you know, of course, at the time, I didn't really realize the significance of it. I was in Jamaica as a little boy, didn't know anything about it. And of course, even now, you remember the powerful images.
The people sitting at home watching was shocked because what we stood for was equality, a social equality. And the structure, the power structure, did not equate black folks with equality.
A lot of black people generally were better off 10, 15, 20 years down the line because they made that stance. So people have a lot to thank them for while they actually suffered.
Tommie Smith and bronze medalist John Carlos were sent home from Mexico and never allowed to compete for the USA again. Back home, both men lost their jobs and faced death threats.
We were athletes dedicated to making a change in the 60s. And that's what we did. We're very proud black men.